shoulder with women in our revolutions as far back as we can remember. Today we're going to meet one of our leaders who has devoted her life to Egyptian women, Dr. Hoda Badran.
My childhood was in a way particular, because when I remember my mother was a descendant of a Turkish family where she was a strong woman, dominant. She was taking care of a lot of things, but she was not as educated as my father. She was rich. Her family was one of these Turkish families whom they came at Muhammad Ali, and Muhammad Ali gave them the land without even getting to pay for it. So, she comes from a Turkish rich family. My father was, on the other end, he wasn't such a rich man. He was comfortable, but he didn't have that much money. He didn't come from a Turkish family, but he came from an ordinary, his farmer was educated. He was very well cultured and educated, while my mother was not that educated. So it was a combination between the two. That one was not that educated, but she was firm. She had the money, a lot of money. The other one doesn't have that much money, but he had the culture. He worked as a professor. So I think I have gained from the two of them. And in the final analysis, they agreed on certain values. And I think coming from the rural areas, the two of them, they were from the rural areas. There are certain values of the rural areas, which I think is very good, it's very useful. And I think that these values have reflected on my behavior a great deal. So both I was very, influenced by the two of them, not just one. And then I came from a big family. And I had, we were eight children. I think if the family can afford, at that time families could afford that, because there was help, more than one maid, there were nurses that could be paid for. So the mother did not have to really be exhausted by a big family. On the other hand, I think I benefited also from having a big family, because the only child is a mistake. I think if I look at it backwards, maybe three were enough. Maybe four is a maximum. But that happened, and as I say, we were eight. So the love was distributed from the parents to the eight of us. We knew, and I knew very early, how to share. And you have to share what you have and what the family have with other children. And I have brothers and I have sisters. It is funny to say that my mother was the one who favored the boys more than the girls. The father did not do that. My father looked at the girls and boys as equal. Nobody has more favors than the others. So he made a balance. So I didn't feel that much that I was discriminated against. And he would favor when we went to school, the one who would make good for school, who would be doing excellent work, then that one would take a bit more of his attention. And I tried hard to be good at school, to be excellent in my class work. And that's why I have to say that I remember he used to give me a bit of attention, because he saw in me that maybe he was clever enough that that was an indication that maybe when I grow and when I go to university, I'd be doing good at school. So this is, in a nutshell, the background during my childhood. Thank you. very young, I went to a nursery school. It was a foreign school. And amazingly enough, at the same time, when we used to go for about a month to our village, because during the summer vacation, my family used to spend 1 month in close to the sea, maybe in Alexandria or someplace on the beach. And we have to spend another month in the village, because my father and my mother had land and they had to go and supervise and so on. So when we used to go to the village, I used to play with the farmers' daughters, and they used to go to, not a madrasa, it was called a kutab. That kutab focuses on how to teach the Quran. And I insisted to go during that month with the girls to the kutab. So I learned the Quran very young. And not just that, I discovered that if you really understand Quran and if you recite it, you'll know the Arabic language very much, good Arabic language. So sometimes now when I correct somebody anything in the Arabic language, and some people think that because I was educated in the United States and so on, that my Arabic would not be that good. So they get astonished. So I tell them, you know, if you in certain statements, if you go back to the Quran, you know how to write and to talk in very good Arabic language. I'll give you just one example, that many people, when they write Arabic, they say al-ghayr muta'allim, for example. This is wrong. You have to say ghayr al-muta'allim. And when you go to the Quran, you say in the Surah Al-Fatiha, you say ghayr al-maghdub alayhim. So if you remember that, and there are a lot of examples like that. So I'm very grateful that, because some people say, why did you go to the kutab? And the kutab is only for the farmers' children. No, I think it was a great privilege to go every year, until, of course, I was older than that and I had other interests. But when I was very young, I used to learn the Quran, I used to speak in a very good Arabic language.
Dr. Hoda got her PhD in social welfare, specializing in community organization and citizens' participation from the School of Applied Social Sciences in Cleveland, Ohio, in 1967.
After finishing my basic education, I finished high school, and I'll tell you, I was the first in the Cairo governorate, and I remember at that time there was the King Farouk. And every year, King Farouk will make a big festival. And those who are getting advanced in the list of graduation, they go and have tea with him in Abdin Palace. And I was very privileged that at that time, you know, high school was not an end that the king would invite. He, at that time, he used to invite university graduates. And my family did not intend that I'll finish and go to university. So I sent a letter to Hassanin Basha telling him that I'm not going to go to university and I'm ending my schooling now. And I'm the first in high school. Why shouldn't you invite me to have tea with the king? And fortunately enough, I got an invitation. And I went there to the palace, and it was just great. We had to line up, and he was standing, Farouk was the king at that time. He was standing, and he shook hands with each of us. And we sat with him, and we had tea. So I always, I remember that. My high school was the end of my schooling. And at that time, most of our generation, it was not necessarily finishing their school by going to university. We used to be married very early. I was 16 at that time. And I got married. I got engaged and got married. My husband was a bit older than myself. He was about 20 years older than myself. So I cut off my schooling. And I was married for about a year and a half. I got pregnant very fast, I don't know why. And I got my child, she's the only child, she's a girl. And unfortunately, he got sick and he died after a year and a half. I was so young, and my father actually asked me, would you like to live alone with your daughter, or would you like to come back and live with the rest of the family? And at that time, I was afraid to live alone. And I thought it's a big responsibility to care by myself for my daughter and for everything. So I preferred to go back and live with my family. And I have to say, I just merged in the family very easily, because at that time, I had a sister who was just she was older than my daughter with about 6 months. So when we came back, my daughter and myself, to merge again in the family, it was easy for me because my daughter, she was about 6 months old. So she was just starting to talk. So my father was her father also. And my mother was her grandmother, but she was almost also like another mother for her. And in that way, after she was 4 years, she went to kindergarten